Welcome to this overview of working with Rule 1 incidents in Railinc's damaged and defective car tracking system known as DDCT. Rule 1 covers the care of freight cars, inspections, repairs to foreign cars, minor defects including car hire implications and dispositions for unacceptable cars, gauges and publications required, and car classification. Rule 1 is also used to report and address truck hunting alerts and equipment advisory notices. Rule 1 alerts are covered in a separate video. Refer to the field manual of the AAR interchange rules for detailed information about interchange rules. In this video, we'll look at the Rule 1 incident workflow basics, including how to create a Rule 1 incident, request and provide disposition, report a car on hold, and view repair history. This video is for handling carriers, car mark owners, and shops. This diagram shows the basic flow of the Rule 1 process. The handling carrier creates a Rule 1 incident and, if needed, creates a defect card, manages disposition with the car owner, and moves the car for repairs to the designated location. Then the receiving shop reports the car on hand, repairs the car, and reports the repairs to DDCT to close the incident. Let's start using DDCT. Log into the launchpad and navigate to DDCT. If you have questions about logging in, watch the DDCT Getting Started video that is part of this video training series. A pop-up box appears asking you to select the company you represent. Let's walk through the process of creating a Rule 1 incident. As we saw in the diagram, whenever defects are discovered, an authorized handling carrier user must create an incident to begin tracking. From the DDC menu bar, select Incidents, Create Incident. The New Car Incident page is displayed. The default incident date is the current date. Use the calendar icon or enter a date to change the date of the incident. By default, Rule 1 is already selected from the Interchange Rule dropdown. If the incident is associated with an alert, use the Alert Type dropdown to select the alert type. For more information about using DDCT to work with alerts, watch the DDCT Rule 1 Alert Incidents video that is part of this video training series. Many input fields in DDCT include sample text or tips as a quick reminder of the format expected in any given input field as seen here with the location, splic, and equipment fields. Enter a location splic or use the magnifying glass to look one up. Enter the specific equipment initial and number. Select Continue. A yellow message is informational and may be a caution that requires some action before you can continue. In this case, an override of the DDCT possession check is needed if the equipment is in possession of the handling carrier on the incident date. DDCT verifies the accuracy of the entered information and displays equipment information. To add a defect to the equipment, select the wheel icon in the action column. Select Add Edit Defects. A blue message provides information about how to use a feature. Scroll all the way down to view defects A through Z. Choose the appropriate defect by selecting the checkbox next to your selection. Select the Save button. The Incident Details page displays the added defect. Page navigation options are available within the incident creation workflow. These options allow you to move from one part of the process to the next. For example, the Next button allows you to move from the Incident Details page to the Request Disposition page to initiate the process. Then you can use the Previous button to move back to the Incident Details page. Select Save Draft if you want to return later to finish, or add an attachment. To view saved incident drafts, select Incidents View Incident Drafts from the menu bar. Choose the incident you want to work on by selecting the Incident ID link. Select the Edit button. To add attachments, use the wheel icon drop-down in the Action column. Once selected, an option appears to add attachments. Attachments can be added when the incident is in draft status. An attachment must follow the file extensions and size specified in the blue message. Use Browse to select your file. Enter the description of the document as required. Select the Upload button to upload your file. Next, select Create from Draft to request disposition. Complete all the fields that have a red asterisk. Enter the contact name, phone, and email. Use the magnifying glass to look up handling car contacts as needed. If the contact is registered in findus.rail, the fields are auto-populated. Select the equipment to request disposition. Complete the other fields for commodity or last loaded commodity, load status, and if the equipment can travel on its own wheels. For the disposition note, select whether equipment has been sent to shop or will be sent to shop, and the disposition shop. Once all fields are entered, select the Request Disposition button and then select Yes to confirm. A green success message indicates a successful submission and in this case shows that your request has been sent to the car mark owner. If you receive a red message, this indicates an error in your entry and you cannot proceed until the entered information is valid. Correct any errors and select the Request Disposition button again. Then select Yes to confirm. Select Done. Once the handling carrier has created the incident, the car mark owner can select a shop couplet, which is a combination of a shop mark and a splick, and provide a shop location for repairs by selecting Defective Cars, Provide Disposition from the menu. When you select the search icon for the shop ID and splick, the shop couplet search opens and shows the capabilities and capacity status information for each shop couplet. Once a car has been dispositioned to a shop, DDCT enables the shop to report the car on hand by selecting Shop Report Car on Hand from the menu. The shop also can select the appropriate button for repairs or inspection by selecting Shop Repair History. Throughout each step of the DDCT process we've seen in this video, email notification messages are automatically sent to the involved parties. To receive these messages, users must be registered in Railinc's findus.rail application. Short training videos on requesting access to findus.rail and adding contacts are available on the findus.rail page at railinc.com. For more details about DDCT, refer to the DDCT documentation and videos by selecting the documentation menu item. That wraps up this overview of using DDCT to work with Rule 1 incidents. Contact us for more information.